Everyone, welcome back to the channel. This is Tripti Parikh, legal intern at Lexis & Company from JNR and Vyas University, Jodhpur. In this video, I will talk about right against self-incrimination in India. Now, what is self-incrimination? Self-incrimination means a declaration or an act that occurs during an investigation where a person or a witness incriminates themselves either explicitly or implicitly. The Indian Constitution provides immunity to an accused against self-incrimination under Article 20, subsection 3. Under Article 20, subsection 3, says that no person accused of an offence shall be compelled to be a witness against himself. Right against self-incrimination, based on the legal maxim, nemo tantum prodeor accusare specie, which means no man is obliged to be a witness against himself. The Supreme Court widened the scope of this immunity by interpreting the word witness to include oral as well as documentary evidence so that no person can be compelled to be a witness to support a prosecution against himself. This prohibition cannot be applied in the cases where an object or the document is searched or seized from the possession of the accused. There is some test which includes in self-incrimination. The first is narcoanalysis test. The admissibility of scientific techniques such as narcoanalysis test, brain mapping test, etc. from improving the investigation has been a matter of debate about whether these tests violate the right against self-incrimination under Article 20, subsection 3. In the case of Govind Singh versus State of Madhya Pradesh, the court held that the mental state of an individual comes under the ambit of right to privacy. Development in the area observed that the authority of the state to compel an individual to expose the part of his life which he wishes to keep himself is ultra vires the constitution as it in the contravention of the right guaranteed under 20 subsection 3 and under Article 20 subsection 3 and under Article 21 of Constitution. The second test is the DNA test. The court are reluctant in accepting evidence based on DNA test because it challenges the right to privacy and right against self-incrimination of an individual. Right to privacy is a right inherent in right to life and personal liberty under Article 21. In some cases, the Supreme Court held that the right to life and personal liberty is not absolute and can be subject to certain restriction. In Kharag Singh versus State of Uttar Pradesh, the Apex Court held that the right to privacy is not guaranteed under Constitution. The court have allowed DNA test on certain occasions to be used in an investigation for producing evidence. Now, there is some ingredients of Article 20, subsection 3. The first is the person accused of an offense. This is privilege is only available to a person accused of an offense. It means person against whom a formal accusation relating to the commission of an offence has been levied, which may be result in prosecution. In India, an FIR or a formal complaint against a person accusing him of committing a crime, it is not necessary that a trial or inquiry should have been concerned before the court. Article 20, subsection 3 operates only on the making of such formal accusation. It is imperative that a person cannot claim the prosecution if at the time he made the statement he was not an accused but became an accused thereafter. Article 20, subsection 3 does not apply to departmental inquiries into allegation against a government servant since there is no accusation of any offense. In case of M.P. Sharma versus Satish Chandra, it was held that a person whose name is mentioned in the first information report as an accused can claim protection under Article 20, Subsection 3. The privilege against self-incrimination is available at both trial and pre-trial stage. It means when the police investigation is going on and the person is regarded as an accused, or even if his name is not mentioned in an FIR as an accused. The second ingredient is compulsion to be a witness. The application of the narco analysis test as a technique for an investigation raises the issue of human rights. In State of Bombay versus Kathi Kalu, the court held that it must be shown that a person was compelled to make a statement which was likely to incriminate him. Compulsion is duness. It should be a physical objective act and not a state of mind like beating, threatening, imprisonment of wife, parent or child of person. Article 20, Subsection 3 does not apply if a person make a confession without any inducement or threat. The third and last ingredient is compulsion resulting in giving evidence against himself. An accused can be compelled to submit to investigation by giving thumb impression or spacing for writing or exposing body for the purpose of identification. In Kalu's case, it was held that it must be necessarily shows that the witness was compelled to make a statement likely to incriminate him. Compulsion is an essential ingredient, but if a person make a confession without any inducement, threat or promise under Article 20, Subsection 3 does not apply. The accused may waive his right against self-incrimination by voluntarily making any oral statement or producing documentary evidence incrimination in nature. So, the three important ingredients of Article 20, Subsection 3 is, first is person must be an accused, second compulsion to be a witness, and third is compulsion resulting in giving evidence against himself. So here it is all about right against self-incrimination under Article 20, Subsection 3. I hope you like my video. Please like, subscribe and comment. Thank you for watching.